Dr. Ghosh, Dr. Krishnamurti, Dr. Iyengar, Swin, Dr. Gandhi, Dr. Padiyar, all the old and new brothers and sisters of CSM CRI. It's such a great feeling to be standing here and talking. And I thought for a change, it need not be very heavy or serious. So that's why the word fun, because I think innovation is fun. There's no greater fun than innovation, which is what I have learned all in my life. And for all in my life, the roots have been CSM CRI. As I'll talk and correlate, I think everything which I did subsequently has been with the base of CSM CRI all along. And that's why I'm particularly happy and excited to be here. And I also congratulate the organizers for thinking of this and having us here to go down the memory lane and remember all those days of fun and innovation. There is a word, when I passed out from IIT, there was a trend. Every fellow wanted to go abroad. In fact, in my class, out of 56, 42 left for USA in a few months. I think what held up people like me here, especially me, was CSM CRI. I thought there is no place better in the world than CSM CRI. In fact, there is a very funny story, because many of my friends were there, and once when I was in USA and was coming back, they said, why are you going back? You know, you have such good job offers, very nice people who are wanting you to be here, a lot of dollars to earn. I said, everything is there, but there is one word for which I'm going back to Bhavnagar. And so they said, what is that word? I said, the word is Amtho. You know, how many of you know the word Amtho in Bhavnagar? Yeah. Just like that. I said, I'm among all the things, what I miss is the word Amtho. And there is no parallel to that aura of Amtho word in the world. And that Amtho thing has remained with me all the time. And that's why I think the fun. I also believe very strongly, after all these years of going round to my total journey, that unless you have fun, you can't do good innovators. And also, when good and bad time comes in your career, it is your sense of humor, it is the fun of the spirit of fun which sustains you and takes you forward. And this I particularly want to say because I see so many young people who are starting on their career or in the middle of the career, and this is exactly what I'm going to be talking about. The way I started my journey here, I moved on to the other places, the kind of ups and downs in life, the good things, and so many other things. You know, when I joined this institute in 1966, Dr. Datar invited me because I did my final year thesis. I was not a great student, but I got so much interested in my final year work of design of a water desalination plant, which this is the problem which was given to me by Professor Kamath at IIT Bombay. And I did a design, and that was appreciated. So in all the other papers, I hardly got passing marks, but in that particular project work, I got an excellent, above 80%. And when I met Dr. Datar and Dr. Datta, even before my result came, they said, you can join. You can take this up and implement for the new plant, design the plant and put it up at the salt farm. Oh, that was a great opportunity, I thought. I also was joking with Dr. Ghosh here that I'm probably the oldest employee of CSFGRI. Can you believe it? I joined CSMCRI in 1956 without any salary. I had won some Hindi debate in Bhavanagar schools, and CSMCRI was very well known for plays. And they were searching for some boy who could speak good Hindi. So I was picked up, and I was brought here at a very young age. I have some archive photograph, I'll try to show you that. And that's how, in 1957, I entered this stage. And the title of the play, I remember, was Basa Basaya Ghar. A boy who wanted to get married, his father was trying, and was not able to find a girl. So this was very clear in my mind, that 66 when I joined, I had three clear goals of joining CSF. One, to do good research, set up that plant, and have fun working. The second one was to learn tennis. We had just picked up tennis things, and when I was general secretary, we made a tennis court here. The fund was not there, so it was put under the soil stabilization research project, and tennis thing started. And the third thing, of course, which was very important, was I wanted to get married, hook up some girls, preferably from Bhavnagar. I succeeded in all the three. But as I go down the memory line, so IIT Bombay, when I entered, I just went as a kid from a very small town boy, I think first from Bhavnagar to enter IIT Bombay, and grew into a full-fledged IITian as they came out, with a lot of stars in the eyes, joined CSMCRI in 1966. And I could see there was a desalination dream. Around the villages when I used to mew, and this was always at the back of my mind, that what you study, what you learn, what expertise you get, in what way it is going to help people. And I knew from childhood the kind of water problem this entire area had, and many other parts. And so I thought this was a great project to work on. In fact, when I met Dr. Datta and said, I'm very keen about desalination, he said, one life is not sufficient to work for desalination. So I said, okay, now I've made a right choice, here I am. Went to USA, made some good friends in Arizona, who has become the permanent, I'll talk about that a little later. And then, much reluctantly, but when I was offered a higher position, and there was a great project with visionary Dr. Vikram Sarabhai to set up a nuclear-powered agro-industrial complex with desalination. And so the team was being built, and I got selected, joined BRC, I left CSMCRI almost with tears in my eyes. And at BRC, though there was a great deal to learn, I was never comfortable, all the time missing CSMCRI. So, but there was a good training, nuclear waste facility, agro-industrial complex, design, project experience, and so on, till I was picked up by GSFC Limited. GSFC, as you know, that time was coming up in a very big way. It had also made very powerful impact in every area. Agrochemicals, fertilizers, petrochemicals, engineering plastics. And so I worked on that and was suddenly given, made to build an entire very large-scale industrial R&D center with multidisciplines and so on. Friends, there is one secret which I want to share. Soon, in a few years' time, I think CSIR had a plan of building the next generation people, for directors, and taking some young people as deputies and grooming it. And if I remember right, three people were selected. Rama Rao, who joined later on and became director of Hyderabad Institute, Mashalkar, and I was selected as the deputy director for this institute. Dr. Sidhu was there. He was very keen that somebody with a background of industrial R&D also comes. I was in dilemma. There was a special board meeting in GSFC, which had never happened in the history, and they bypassed all the rules, promoted me as the director of the Research and Innovation Center, and they said, we will not let you go. I remember Dr. Taqvi Khan even coming to Baroda once and persuading that you should come and join. It was very difficult not to join. But then Baroda was there, and I also knew that at CSMCRI I am always a boy, and I will continue that association all the time. But let me tell you that all along CSMCRI remained all throughout as the foundation for everything that I did. We won several awards for biofertilizers, which I had initiated, and that was one of the reasons. In one of the celebrations, the Chief Minister of Gujarat came, and he said, I'm very happy GSFC has won all these productivity awards, and now I'm taking Dr. Mehta as the Vice Chancellor of GAU. It was the largest university in Asia, campus-wise, the farm-wise, and so on, dairy, animal husbandry, all different crops, and so on, fisheries. I was reluctant, but it was Dr. Kurian, my predecessor, who persuaded that you can do a lot in the South. I landed in GAU, and I think that was a very good experience. We could turn around, we could do a lot in the agri-development of Kutch after the disaster, and introduce the thing which I had learned all along, especially during my stay at CSMCRI, working at the experimental farm, that what you do, how do you reach maximum people? And I think this is going to be one of the most important things which you will have to keep in mind. We talked about technology transfer, we talked about other issues. What you do, how it is going to be benefiting the smallest man. And so here I am now. We have an NGO called the Science Ashram, especially for that, of which came out a biotech company to make new generation agri-biotech, because that is the revolution which is going to come now. And the next green revolution is going to be the evergreen or eco-friendly agriculture revolution. So Gujarat Life Sciences, and also I spent some time as the chairman of the national committee. But archives, this is me, if you don't look at my hair now. And I had won a school competition speaking in Hindi, and that's why I landed with a job, of course, unpaid job, at CSMCRI in 1957 about the play which I mentioned, Basa Basaya Ghar. CSMCRI, apart from good research, was also very well known in Bhavnagar as a very good institute for plays and dramas. And I think this is how I started. But when I was coming and looking around, I said, this is one place I must come and work someday. And so it just happened that I came, joined, got involved with the first 1,000 gallons per day water desalination plant using HD technique of desalination. Exactly similar work was going on in Arizona, Tucson. Solar tilts were about to be completed, And we started thinking that there has to be a more efficient process. In solar, you know, solar steel, when you do, you need heating to be done at highest temperature and condensation at the lowest temperature. So why not separate out? So the solar collectors were separated out, and then humidification and dehumidification. It was quite an experience working on this. I remember working late hours. I had a good salary of 350 rupees at JRF. She used to travel there, and when we now talk about this thing, we thought money cannot be bought. So all the workers would work in the evening because May would be very hot there. So we would work in the evening and night for putting up the solar collectors. And I used to carry gantia from my own pocket and keep all the workers happy about it. Dr. Iyengar remembers this man. As I said, at practically at the same time in Arizona or Mexico, a similar desalination plant was being set up by one Carl Hodges. Carl and I have remained friends since 64 till today, as one of the closest friends. But it started there, and when the first water desalination conference ever in India was held here, I was just standing here and making presentation. Carl was very much there. And some of the old stalwarts objected to what I was talking, that somebody said that setting up such a plant near the coastal area will not be good because humidity is high and so on. It was Carl who came and supported, but ever since we have been friends. But what I want to tell you is, based on this, Carl has gone great places, became one of the main advisors of President of USA, and an authority setting up large seawater-based agriculture farms. And I remember he and I went going to Dr. Iyengar and Dr. Kurian, and he taking keen interest that ultimately, if desalinated water is always going to be costly, why not seawater agriculture? And I, from chemical engineering, got interested in agriculture right from those days. It was a wonderful experience when Carl, after almost 20 years, came back to visit me, and at the when I was the Vice Chancellor of Gujarat Agriculture University, and together we again planned an aqua agro complex with halophytes. The team, as I said, I had three major goals when I joined CSM CRI. So I was General Secretary, Dr. Datar as the President, and this was our team which did all those things about the, especially tennis and many other activities. So I got this from the archives. Then I got married. And both Dr. Mehta and Dr. Datta almost wrote me off as a research man. He said, now this guy is not interested in anything but the girl. So this was my reception when they came, along with one Mr. Gupte, a very, very interesting and intelligent officer whom we had. And Dr. Datta kept away. He was my boss. And door se namaskar karke bol diya, abhi khatam dwara khel. But anyway, I got married, but he challenged me a few times that, Dr. Mehta, I think now you're not like earlier days, you know, so on. So there was another challenging project which was taken up, was the condensation system, the spirally enhanced tubes. We worked very hard on this. Hargobind Patel is here. And we took the first patent, probably the first engineering patent of CSM CRI in those days. Must have written several times, and ultimately we got the patent. So one of the first patents where a workshop illiterate man who has worked with me on developing these tubes, because these tubes have a very far-fetching interest in the overall efficiency of the desalination plants. It was a big craze in those days. And we included Van Jadhav also as in patent writing. And when I asked him to sign, he asked me what I'm signing. He signed in Gujarati, of course. And I said, we are taking a patent and I'm putting your name also. And he had tears rolling down his eye. He said, I never imagined that I will be given this honor. But it was a great teamwork and there was a lot of fun. As I said, C.S. Damsraya lives with you. And this happened when, long after this, I was giving a talk in Kalpakkam. We had lost almost 40 of our senior scientists of atomic energy. You know, Kalpakkam, Indira Gandhi Atomic Research Station, soon after the tsunami. And we were working on bioshield. With my background on agriculture, this came in more handy. And we said you could combine this with the seawater treatment with the halophytes and all that. And we set up the first bioshield demonstration plant. When I was giving this talk and I said bioshield could have helped you, Kakodkar was there, as my old friend, and he said, here is the money, you take it and you set up a demo plant. And so the nation's first systematic bioshield demo project was set up in Kalpakkam. Now there is something very typical, because this has the, we formed a consortia with the Science Ashram, Varoda, Swaminathan Foundation, Navsari Agriculture University, CSMCRI team, thanks to Dr. Ghosh and his team, and IGCA. Because we said, as you go from the sea toward the land, it should not be monoculture. You start with halophytes, like Saliconia, or any other kind of halophytes which can grow in that area. Then go for the second phase, and then only go for the big tree. Because monoculture is never good. I'm very glad this has been successfully set up now, and Atomic Energy hopefully will take BioShield as an integral part of all their new establishment for power plants. As I said, in very early days I learned, and I think most scientists feel, you are happy when your technology goes to people. You are more happy when your technology fruits are used by the smallest people. And this, what I learned at CSMCRI, remained more strongly in the later on years. That was the reason, if you look at, friends, the agriculture research, where India had done so well, bringing the Green Revolution, the transfer of technology from the research institute or universities in agriculture system, it's hardly 5%. It is rated as 5%. Of all the knowledge that we have, only 5% goes to the farmers. And that's why they have a lot of emphasis. And with that 5%, even in USA, it is considered to be not more than 9%. So that is the situation. And with 5%, we brought the Green Revolution. So you can imagine what you can do. Now, you know, you do farm demonstrations, you have meetings with the farmers, you have meetings with the other experts and so on, but how much you can reach? So my interaction with ISRO people came in very handy, and we set up a GAU satellite, Krushi Goshti, to reach maximum number of farmers. It was very interesting because when I commissioned it, we were sitting in the studio, the governor is sitting by my side, and we were trying to, sitting in Gandhinagar studio, I had people in Kutch, I had people in Junagadh, I had people in Balsar, and many small farm houses, all talking directly to the scientist about technology. And I think it's a very powerful tool which we must adopt for all the other institutions as well. And the first question this lady asked me when we started, she said, sir, this is very good. Avkash ni vaat karo jo moti. But I have two buffaloes. Mare be bhens che. Your technology in what way is going to help me? And I think this was the toughest question I ever answered in my life. And then, of course, I said, from here we'll give you information about the kind of diseases, the kind of fodder, selecting that and so on. And then she was very happy. In fact, at the end of the year, we gave her an award of 50,000 rupees, Sardar Patel Krushi Award, for asking the best question and making it most difficult for the Vice Chancellor to answer. This was another group which was asking, but it's amazing that, especially during crisis, please don't underestimate the average farmer or even average worker. They know what is good for them. So you go with the right thing, they will adopt it. This is what we have learned all over, and I'm learning it every day now more and more. This is how later on we extended this for planning of all the water bodies and water systems. It's Dr. Swaminathan sitting there, I sitting there, and then all the other thing in Danduka, Tansa, Nosari, and so on. I often talk, and recently I gave a talk in the research conclave at IIT. Research and innovations have grown. Have our innovation and management of innovation have grown simultaneously or not? This was a great example which I picked up from the story of Nuclear India. When the swimming pool reactor, and I'm correlating because I know many of you have similar experiences here and there. Men like Dr. Bhava, when they were commissioning the first swimming pool reactor, or which was later on named as Apsara. And he said, I want two cars for the disposal because my scientists are working late. And second, lunch and dinner for these scientists. They were half a dozen. But he knew there will be audit objection. So he writes to the Prime Minister, to whom he was reporting anyway, both A and B are not permitted by government regulation, and I need your approval. And probably he must have sent the letter or the file by the afternoon flight from Bombay to Delhi. Prime Minister agreed. He said, I agree. I didn't know about this during my CSMCRI days. I know. Like the tubes I wanted to buy, and I had put it through the purchase, it was taking months. So once I had my salary, 350 rupees, in 40 rupees I got two aluminum tubes from the Lokhand Bazar. So, but I know CSIR and CSMCRI have gone great places, both also in the freedom and the encouragement for innovation, and these are very good signs. I also want to convey, after having gone through all these type of institutions in different capacities, and I come to this model, which I am very sure, what you need is a golden triangle for any great institution. And I would put CSMCRI as small, but probably one of the most efficient institutions outward-wise in the country. And what you need is good scientists, sometimes almost crazy, a science manager who is visionary, dynamic, competent leader. Could be director of an institute, or director general, or head of an institution, or so on. And third, the most important, is a handholder. An enlightened, bold, and encouraging top management. We have several examples. DAE, Baba Nehru, Amul, Kurian, and a very silent man driven by Patel, who if he was not there, Kurian couldn't have done what he did. ISRO, Vikram Sarabhai, Indira Gandhi. Vikram Sarabhai could walk in to Indira Gandhi's office or at home any time that he liked. That was the kind of thing which he had. The Great Green Revolution, thanks to ICR, Swaminathan, Subramanian. I also know the full story of Tennessee Valley Authority. There's a beautiful book on Tennessee Valley Years by David Lilienthal, who had put Roosevelt as the handholder. We also had, when I remember vividly, as a young boy, I used to watch Jivraj Mehta was the chairman of the first board. And he would, with half-closed eyes, but the right encouraging person, which I found out when, you know, we were asked to set up a desalination plant for INS Vikrant. And Dr. Datta took me to his home in Pedder Road. And I remember the way, very silently, but the way he supported this. Laid a good foundation in the beginning. Friends, with this, I thought I'll just tell you, but as I said, getting more interested in science, it started in the last few years, you start also understanding the meaning of science, the meaning of your innovation, and the need for a holistic approach. That was the reason, probably, I wrote a book of poems. I could do that. I assure you, it wasn't during the office hours of CSMCRI. And the second book was on science, spirituality, and the world tomorrow. Last year, Dr. Kalam released the book and told me that the new phase of science and science innovation and the institution building is coming, where in the years to come, it would be science for maximum people, spirituality as emboldened to science, and the world tomorrow. So every young person who is sitting here and listening, you do corporate plan for everything. You do SWOT analysis. Now the institutions also are doing strength, weakness, opportunities, threat. How does a scientist does the corporate plan of his life? What do you want to do with your life? You want a safe, secure, dull life? I have seen in many organizations, in teachers, in institutions, said, why work? No, everybody gets promotion. Or ultimately, you left out. So half of them spending time on share bazaar and so on. So you have a choice of a safe, secure, but very dull life. Or you can have an exciting, innovative, often risky, but searching life. Because ultimately you will realize that you are happiest when you are living for others. You are happiest when you want to give maximum to the society. Because you are the world. If you go sometimes in the villages around, there's a lot of wisdom of seemingly ignorant people. And you will often hear one bhajan. Mauj mein rehna, khoj mein rehna. Mauj ma rehu, khoj ma rehu. And I think that those are the people who give you the right message when you are doing innovation. Be happy, be in search. May God bless you. Thank you.